So the next thing we're going to look at is multiple layer control and options. So how do multiple layers interact with one another? So the first thing I'm going to do is go ahead and clear and sneak this away. And let's set up a couple of layers. So let's say 5.11 through 5.13, which is my server layer as well as two of my content layers. I'm going to put those at full. I'm going to grab channel 5.12, which is my first media layer, and get some content on it. I'm going to go over here to my library. I want to find file number 39, which is the ETC logo. The ETC logo is a little large, so I want to bring it way down. I'm going to take my scale and put it at 5%. That'll shrink it way down and bring it onto the screen. And I want it slightly off the screen. I'm going to put my pan at negative 25 and my tilt at positive 25. Slide that off the screen a little bit. And then I want to add content to my Lex layer. So I'm going to grab 5.13. It's already at full. And for this, I'm going to find my file 65. I also want to scale that down to 5%. And I'm going to pan 20 and tilt negative 20. So we'll go to the opposite corner. So the first thing to notice about interactions between two layers is opacity. I still have 5.13 selected. So as I roll out that intensity, you'll notice that I can start to see my channel 5.12 behind it. Keep in mind that higher number channels are on top of lower number channels. So as higher number channels come online, they cover up the lower number channels. In addition to opacity, there is the mask function and the mixer mode function that help determine how layers that are stacked on top of one another interact. If you want more information on this, check out the workbook.